All right, welcome to Smokey's Footy Files, and on this one, we are checking out the most recent iteration of All or Nothing. This time, it is Arsenal. I would like to start out by saying that I'm going to be watching the entire season first to see not just Arsenal either, so don't let's not go there either. I'm trying to see what teams I like, so I'm going to try and watch as many matches as possible and then pick a team off of whoever I fuck with the most based off of that. And yeah, really, who's also smoking the goalie the way I like to see a goalie get smoked? Because I have a lot of respect for the keeper, because I'm like, my nigga, that's a pressure position. So I respect it. And I respect it so much, I want to just see them get smoked in the most disgraceful manner. It's just hilarious. Like, damn, that nigga did that to him. Can't believe you let that happen to you. Not on a Friday. You gotta fix your life, my guy. But that said, please continue to put me on to like compilation videos and stuff like that, because I am trying to learn as much as I can about the sport, because I did not grow up with this at all, and I had no idea it was going to be so political in picking a team. So now that I know that, we are going to actually do the diligence of actually picking a team, because Jesus Christ, it's going to be a fucking war. Y'all are crazy. I didn't know it was this deep. Hey, just help me pick a team, because I seen the thing about Premier like starting. Oh my God, what did I get myself into? But yeah, it's like I signed up for a gang war. I just haven't picked it. It's the only time in life you can actively and openly pick a gang, but you're still going to be judged for whatever gang you pick. But this is for sure a gang war. This is for sure a gang war. We just fight each other on a pitch. But yeah, let's get into this one. This is episode 1 of All or Nothing Arsenal. Let's go. Let's check it out. They got off the tube. Fly Emirates.
Because you love what you do. That is called passion.
Passion. I refuse to believe that this nigga is the coach. I don't care. You guys are going to tell me that's him. My firm belief is that's a nigga with a bad knee. He's just helping out. He'll be back out next 2-3 weeks. Maybe get one of them stem cell treatments. Maybe one of those little rotoscopic surgeries, clear his knee out. But that nigga, yeah, he'll be back on the pitch soon. He's coming back.
Only passion, determination and passion, and show these people how much you care. And go out there and play forward and attack them. And play with courage and belief and fucking win this game.
Bing!
Arsenal Football Club. In the heart of North London. It's one of the biggest football clubs in the world.
Are they really in the heart of North London? Or this is a little creative license because we're talking about ourselves. So, nigga, we are the heart.
A history of style.
Big men. I don't know none of these people.
They were champions. Invincibles.
An entire Premier League season unbeaten.
That's a feat right there. That's a feat.
But recently things have not been so good.
And for the first time in more than 20 years, there will be no European football for this great club.
The fans are restless.
We used to always be in the Champions League. All the time, without fail. And now we can't even make Europa.
It's funny to me. Well, it's just probably heartbreaking to y'all, but it's funny to me because I'm just like, damn, that nigga really shitted on the niggas with that Europa. Like, that shit really hurt some niggas. Like, yeah, we really can't even make Europa. I'm just like, the fact I knew what that league was, and now I know that that's a shit league too. Well, not a shit league, but it ain't compared to the Premier, and it's not compared to the fucking Champions League. It's underneath all that, so I was like, oh, shit. God damn it.
Manager.
As a manager, you're going to be under pressure. You're going to be questioned.
Nah, you just helping out, bro. You got to get back on the pitch.
For the first time in their history, Arsenal have allowed cameras behind the scenes.
I don't speak often. When I speak, it's from the heart, innit?
And what would prove to be a pivotal season for the club. With the drama unfolding on
and a red card
and off the pitch.
When I lose a duel, I am upset. Because that's the fucking standard.
We have decided as a club that...
I was going to ask, were there soccer coaches that yelled? Because I was like, yo, that nigga Marino, he don't raise his voice for shit. Not a goddamn thing. So I'm happy to see that there's somebody that does yell.
He's no longer our captain.
Ooh. I kick Wiley off the team? That's crazy.
Is Mikel Arteta demand to take Arsenal and their fans back to the big time?
We have a challenge, guys. It's a beautiful challenge. Let's go for it. It's a beautiful challenge. Let's go for it.
Is that grass special made for me to be able to slide on it like that? Narrated by Daniel Kaluuya.
It's a new beginning at Arsenal. The start of a season that will see the fans return to the stadium. London Colney is Arsenal's training ground where the preparations begin.
Hey, Cedric, Zambi Park in your sport. Why are you looking at me?
Niggas got a gold Lambo. Then I got a gold jacket, gold Lambo. That nigga better be nice wearing all this goddamn gold. Where my nigga Jesus at?
Arsenal have several established stars.
Like, what the fuck is going on in here?
Arsenal have several established stars, including club captain Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. But their squad is mainly made up of players under 25. In fact, Arsenal have the youngest squad in the Premier League. One of their most exciting young players is 19-year-old Bukayo Saka.
Bukayo.
From the moment Arsenal scouted me, I think there was only one choice. I do remember the scouts approach your parents and they give them like a card with the Arsenal badge on. I remember getting into the car and my dad showing me, and I think I just took the card and I just held it for me for a few days with me. As a kid, you know, you play for fun, and then when you see the teams that you're watching on TV are calling for you, you know, it's special. So I was really excited and I wanted to get started straight away.
Bukayo played for England in the final of the European Championship. He was chosen to take the last kick in the penalty shootout.
Oh, is this the little nigga that missed? He was talking about this little nigga crazy.
This moment in English football in over 50 years.
No, you don't. No, you don't. I'm not letting y'all let that one down. Keep it 100. Little nigga missed it. It happens. Exactly. Why? And that's the crazy thing. Even in this TV show, they're going to focus on it. Like, his penalty kick was not the third one. Like, two other niggas didn't miss beforehand, but let's put it on the littlest nigga out there. What are we doing with ourselves? Nah, bro, you shouldn't feel bad at all. Fuck that shit. Nigga, I missed it. We'll be back tomorrow. Yeah, that shit don't matter, blood. That shit don't matter. We'll come back.
A wave of racial abuse.
It's all right, bruv. It's all right.
His performance in the tournament and the way he handled the attention made him a household name.
Oh my God.
If you step to take that penalty,
big man.
Oh, a hero for me. I don't, obviously, you score, he's better. Understand.
Oh, he does have a fucking English accent.
What he's doing
right now. Or no, fucking French accent.
How humble he is. And it's great because he's from the academy and he's Arsenal through and through. But people do not realize the pressure of being the one that's going to make it. You got to be that when you step on the field. You have to be that. But then people do not care about how you feel as a human being. And this is where it becomes difficult.
That's why you say fuck them.
You know, I think
fuck them. Healthy dose of that will be okay for you.
Can't really do them anymore.
What? They bring the plate to the player over there? American football players could never.
At home, if I cook, my egg is well done, so.
The fuck is a well done egg?
Flo, what did I tell you I did yesterday?
He says he apparently went to wait for grab a
bro, on my life, bro, I swear, the whole staff waited outside for me, bro.
What? This has got to be a special experience for these kids. Most of the team is under 25. We're playing for millions of fucking dollars. We're prime athletes in the fucking earliest parts of our fucking youth. Fuck, I got 2 cents over lunch money. Oh my God. This is probably like going to the best university in the world, but all you study is some shit you actually care about. It's just gotta be lit.
Bro, I walked in, yeah. I think they must have
recognized. I walked in, yeah.
Bro, I had my hood on, my mask, that beard. And I still recognize. Bro, when I was leaving, bro, that the whole, like, 8 staff were waiting outside at the entry, like, back on the side. No, they were just, as soon as I came out, I need a picture. Bro, I had my hood on and my mask, bro. I don't know what more I can do, bro.
When I was a kid, I didn't really think about this side, you know, I just thought about the football side. I didn't really know about off the pitch stuff, you know, the media and stuff like that. But yeah, I don't think I would change it because, you know, I'm still living the dream that I've always dreamt.
This young squad is led by the Premier League's youngest manager, 39-year-old, former Arsenal captain, Mikel Arteta.
Morning, Kelly.
Arteta is under pressure. Since he became manager, Arsenal have been inconsistent, and this season, things need to change.
The expectations of this club are to win every single game. We want to be in Europe, yes, and we will have to win trophies. That's a yes.
You are a winger and you're bringing the ball here. What is the center back? There, yeah?
My main objective is for the fans to believe in the team that has been lost a little bit in the last few years. Football is about trying to give positive emotions to people. And if we are able to do that, hopefully, beautiful things will happen.
What I was thinking is, if you kind of do a little hello, good to see you all back. Here we go again.
In the media, questions hang over Mikel and his ability as a manager.
Morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Suck your mum through your nan's baddie, Chris.
It's your third season, isn't it? 2 8th place finishes. Do you get the sense this is now your time to deliver?
Our goal is to get the best version.
Version?
That's going to bring us closer to winning football matches. That's what I want from the team. On Friday, win against Brentford. And we put so much work and effort in the last few weeks to get the best possible preparation. And now you want to see the outcome. So, ready for the kickoff.
Thanks, Michelle.
Thank you.
Is this show active season or fucking last season?
Arsenal's first match is against newly promoted.
I'm high as fuck. It's giving me dates right here. I'm tripping.
Promoted Brentford. It's a game they're expected to win, but COVID has affected their build-up to the game, and things have just got worse.
If you've not heard the news, both Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang and Alex Lacazette are not involved tonight because they're ill.
And of course, the pre-match homage to Black Lives Matter will continue.
Who's out here kneeling? Hey, why my nigga not kneeling, bro? What's up with this guy? What's up with Blood? Or because he's on everybody on the ops team, they didn't do the kneel. Because if that's the case, all right, I ain't got no beef.
Continue for this season ahead. Good to see, and of course, young Bukayo Saka on the bench there.
And off we go.
Arsenal start well and are dominating their opponents. But just 20 minutes in.
Somebody has to have torn an ACL hitting this motherfucking soccer slide. This shit just looks so dangerous on a nigga knee.
And after 60 minutes, Mikel brings on Bukayo Saka.
That's not just the Arsenal fans. That is all of the Brentford fans applauding Bukayo Saka under the pitch after he missed that penalty.
He can't change Arsenal's fortunes.
Saka towards the left-hand side where it's pulled across to Granit Xhaka. A low shot, but wide of the post. Sorensen with the long throw this time, which bounces right across the penalty area. It's headed in! It's a second goal for Brentford!
Mikel's hopes of giving Arsenal fans a positive start to the new season are over.
Arsenal fans are being waved away. They're leaving the ground.
For the fans, a defeat against Brentford is unacceptable. The fallout begins.
Fucking embarrassing.
We are up the league.
By 2-0. The pressure is on these now. There's going to be no excuse here to look at the next two games. Chelsea, Manchester City, and I think that is why I feel the pressure's right on Mikel Arteta. Rightly or wrongly, that's where we are.
As a manager, you're going to be under pressure. You're going to be questioned. You're going to have to deal with issues. It's part of my job. And I really want to fight for this club. I want to fight for our players, our fans, that they feel the same way and we can do it together.
Fuck the process.
Reached a new low in April 2021. The fans objected to the club agreeing to join the proposed breakaway European Super League. The majority of the anger was directed at the owners of the club, the Kroenke family.
How can a football club have an owner that doesn't care? I don't understand that. When they take us out and put us in a Super League, lad, come on, man.
Kroenke Sports and Entertainment was founded by Stan Kroenke. It's the largest privately owned sports empire in the world. The company is reportedly worth around $10 billion. And when it comes to Arsenal, Stan's son Josh is one of the four club directors.
What's the most challenging thing about running a football club?
Where should I start? My family really just took control of the club in 2018. There's always going to be a bit of a transition period where maybe you don't get everything correct the first time around. There will be bumps, and you just have to be strong enough to withstand them.
We want Kroenke, we want Kroenke, we want Kroenke, we want Kroenke.
very tough period, I knew we had upset a lot of people. And it stinks. I understand that we have a long way to go to build back the trust with our fan base, but it's already started behind the scenes.
Josh has flown into London to meet technical director Edu Gaspar and CEO Vinay Venkatesham. Along with the Arsenal board, Josh has approved a plan to upgrade the first team squad.
So we still, of course, as you're going to see here, we still think a lot of things to do. And when you see like that kind of situation, that's what I want to do until the end of the transfer window. I try to clean and rebalance that position. As you see, Martin is in the building already, which is a very important position because before you just have a Smith Rowe in that position. Now we have a true number 10. Martin gives us a lot of flexibility.
We've also done what we wanted to do about the age profile of the squad. If you look at the players we brought in, all 21, 22, 23, 24.
Josh and the Arsenal board have bankrolled a £30 million transfer for Norwegian wonder kid Martin Odegaard.
Are you happy? Good.
Happy to be back, bro.
Is this kid any good?
I heard what wages you were getting, so I thought, fucking hell.
And the deals for several other young players have been secured. 21-year-old Albert Sambi-Lokonga, £15 million. 21-year-old Nuno Tavares, £7 million. But the most expensive new signing is 23-year-old Ben White, bought for £50 million.
It's good money, boys.
Kids actually giving me snacks. Giving me right off.
Where are
they? For like, £50 million, you're shit.
Arsenal are now the highest spenders in this summer's transfer window and are still looking for more players.
The grand plan should be coming a little more obvious after this transfer window.
You have some pace there. You're ready to play. Hey, you have pace.
I think that you see us out there really looking for young talent that can grow with the group.
How are you?
I'm good, Josh.
You good?
Yeah. You're been good? A tough week. You know, after the first defeat in the Premier League, you know what is coming. The tsunami is coming already on day one.
Yeah.
Clouds are dark.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I meant when I said that technically. Shake that shit off if you got a bright
picture. He gets a clap now in every stadium that he goes, he gets a clap.
After 18 months away from the Emirates Stadium, the fans are back. It's going to be a tough match against European Champions League holders, Chelsea.
You've got Chelsea this weekend. Then Man City. I mean, this is not looking the easiest start you could have had to this season.
I know the people who have the intentions to bury us, to try to criticize us. We are not interested in that.
Who were you talking about there? Were you talking about ex-players? In the Rwandan president was very critical of your game last week. He said Arsenal must not accept mediocrity.
Arsenal spent more money than any other Premier League club this summer.
Has this been your biggest challenge since becoming Arsenal boss?
So the players aren't feeling any pressure, you're not feeling any pressure.
You don't feel pressure in football, in any elite sport. I think you picked the wrong profession.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Well done. Go pretty straight.
It went intense today.
Yeah. And you saw the Ramsdale stuff kind of came out.
Yeah.
Talk Sport, sports update.
Arsenal have announced the signing of goalkeeper Aaron Ramsdale and a long-term deal from Sheffield United.
After weeks of negotiation, Arsenal have secured a £30 million deal for 23-year-old English goalkeeper Aaron Ramsdale.
You on your own?
Yeah.
He just needs to pass his medical with club doctor Gary O'Driscoll.
So look, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Jeez, that's taken a bit of time. We're thrilled to have you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So have you done medicals before?
Yeah.
You are a goalkeeper, right or left-handed?
Right.
And footed?
Right.
Are you married or partner or kids? You've got a partner?
Yeah.
By the end of today, I'll give you my number and any issues that you've got or your partner's got or whatever, family, any issue at all, then you just give me a call, we'll sort that out. So, no injuries at the moment?
No.
When were you last injured?
What, which stopped me from playing?
Yeah. Can you? Oh, good. If you can't remember, that's great. Arm, elbow?
No.
Wrists?
No.
Fingers, hands, no brick. Also broke a couple of.
Broken form.
Any issues since then?
No. It was a Bennett's fracture.
That's it? No other injuries? Have you ever had surgery? Have you ever had any operation at all? Groins, hernias?
Actually, I was about 10 and I broke my arm.
Remember how you did that? Not better not to ask?
Fell off a skateboard trying to go down a slope.
Yeah. You're a great goalkeeper in the making there, I like it.
I played outfield, kicking about in the fields with my dad and my brothers, and my dad just said, where do you want to play? And I said, in goal, and he just turned around and said, are you mad? And I just like shrugged my shoulders. I think it was just the thrill of sort of diving around in the mud, making saves, just being sort of dopey and a joker and stuff like that.
Do you know any of the lads here?
Ben, Bakayo, Emil, Reese.
They're all through England?
Yeah, and I know Rob a little bit through.
Oh, great.
When I was at Bolton.
You were at Bolton as well, yeah?
As a kid, yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
When I was in the academy at Bolton, obviously getting a couple of contracts, sort of from 12 to 16, you realise that you do have a talent because you're in the academy for a reason, but I don't think it was until when I turned probably 17, 18, I started having a better time at Sheffield United, and I was really part of that squad. And that's probably when I thought, well, I've got a chance. And then obviously 6 months later, I was in Bournemouth.
The season before he was at Bournemouth, they got relegated. I think it's a lot of money.
I don't quite get the Ramsdale one, if I'm honest.
They are banter FC right now.
I made a decision to turn all my comments and things off on Instagram and Twitter. Don't need to listen to it. The only person's opinion I need to listen to is the manager's. He picks the team. I need to listen to my teammates' opinions and my family, who have been there through thick and thin, who have seen my journey.
God damn right. Fuck them folks.
People are jealous. People are fickle. People think they can do better. It's a cop-out, in my opinion. You're hiding behind a keyboard. It's just an easy way out for them. And if you start reading it, just comes bad for you, and obviously bad for your mental state. But I think judge me at the end, and we'll see what the reception's like then.
Second league match of the season is against Chelsea. Arsenal have captain Aubameyang back. He's on a subs bench after recovering from COVID. But £50 million defender Ben White is now out with the virus. Mikel needs his team to perform in front of their home fans, otherwise the crowd could turn against them.
You do wonder how long the home support will back the team if things don't improve. Because if the Arsenal fans had been in the ground last season, they would have let the players and the manager know their feelings.
Being an Arsenal fan right now sucks. Oh, let's be honest, like, it ain't, there's nothing to really cheer about. So many lows, especially since we used to have so many highs. We used to always be in the Champions League. It's tragic.
So why do you stick with them then?
Because you have to. I can't just being a Chelsea fan now, or a Tottenham, no, I couldn't even.
Come on, let's go. Get together, come on.
Okay, this week, guys, I think we all been hurt. We all been hurt because somebody, people, has touched our pride. And I saw you after the game and how much you care, and it hurts me. It has me for you, for all the staff, and all the people that cares for us in the football club. Not for me, the criticism or nothing. For you guys, and because I know how hard you fucking try. But today we have a possibility to make a... point here. And it's when everybody's against you, You are stronger here, guys.
Arsenal must pick up the pace in their home opener as the Gunners welcome European champions Chelsea to Emirates Stadium. Romelu Lukaku is thrust straight into the limelight following his near £100 million move from Inter. Guess there for a start, just listen to this. As Premier League football returns to the Emirates Stadium.
Despite the roar from the home fans, Arsenal are immediately under pressure. And Chelsea land the first blow.
Here is James, right-hand side, inside the penalty area. Low ball in, chance for Lukaku, taken! The big money signing comes good very early on here, and it was a simple tap-in. Alonso, good work from Havertz. This is Romelu Lukaku, and now it's with Mount towards James, who puts it into the back of the net with real panache.
2-0 down, and the energy within the stadium is low.
It's half time here at the Emirates Stadium. Well, one or two boos from the Arsenal supporters.
Is so high, we are going back, trying to stay in front of him, let him in offside.
How can we solve that? Or we call the winger to close to Mason, and you are in front of Lukaku? It's the only chance you have.
Guys, Lukaku is dictating the height of our line. If Lukaku is here, we are here, and the ball is there. We have to dictate where we want the ball, and we have to play him offside every time the ball is under pressure, so he has to be squeezing with us. We have some chances. We are arriving. We have corners. We need a goal. We need a goal to give us hope and give us energy. But whatever happens, I don't want one fucking player complaining, one fucking player walking. Is it clear? Let's go.
We're underway for the second half here.
As the second half begins. Arsenal need to find a way to get the crowd going.
This is Saka, invited to shoot. Does just that and tipped over by Mendy. Terrific hit. Taken deep towards the back post, knocked back in, and the header does go in, does he? No, it's wide of the target, Rob Holding. Martinelli, a twist and a turn, tries to slip it through towards Aubameyang, who looked offside. Here is Oba, straight down the throat of Mendy. Reece James. Mason Mount. Mr. Wells. Lukaku again! Terrific save from Bernd Leno onto the woodwork.
But the fact of the matter is, it's not a good day at the office for Arsenal.
That is full time. Mikel Arteta has got some work to do here.
Back-to-back defeats, and the critics are louder than ever.
Yeah, we've got all this nice stadium, but at the end of the day, there just doesn't seem to be a fire like the bellies of the Invincibles, you know?
Get the manager out!
Get
now.
Arteta out now, right now!
Fans, we're all feeling devastated, mate. We know Arteta out now. Gone. He needs to go.
Two games, zero points.
No, what time do you want? Can you
finish the game? Time for
I think we should give him some time.
No, what time?
I think the squad has to come together. The squad hasn't come together yet. I think we should give him some time. He's a young manager. He deserves support. Don't be on him just because he lost a few games.
Some fans wait after the game to shout abuse at the Arsenal manager.
Arteta, was that good enough?
We've got a young team, so we're going to get some difficult moments. I said to you yesterday, you know what it's like in football and sport. When you're winning, everybody's always together. Winning hides everything. When
we have that difficult... After a defeat like that, you're always going to feel... If things are going poorly, that's when the fingers will come up to the director's box because people are looking for change. And for better or for worse, that's the way it works across, you know, all of professional sports.
You have to go through different moments, some very difficult, some when people are trying to stamp you, criticism is coming. And you have to stand up and fight for yourself and believe in what you do. We've had a lot of pressure and criticism, but as a club, we need to stand up to show the togetherness that we have here and go again.
Games don't get easier. Next up, it's the Premier League champions, Manchester City. And for Mikel, it's a trip back to the club where he was assistant manager under Pep Guardiola.
Off we go then. Jesus. Into Silva again, buzzing around as he often does. Jesus with the... It's a good one into the back post, and City take the lead. Cancelo, Gundogan again. Now Silva to deliver. A different type of delivery, but it's gone all the way through. And Manchester City double their advantage.
You get the feeling this could be a very long afternoon.
The Arsenal fans. Crunching challenge from Xhaka on Cancelo. Xhaka. Arsenal's afternoon goes from bad to worse.
Enough is enough, it seems, for some of the Arsenal fans as they head for the exits.
We just want to compete and show a little bit of fight, and out there not showing enough. And we've got, you can still hear us singing. You can't hear the City fans, you see Saka and Emil Smith Rowe. It's just upsetting because the passion we've got, we just don't feel it's being reciprocated on the pitch.
We've got Jack Grealish into play on the left-hand side. Grealish one-on-one up against Chambers, still Grealish into the middle.
Man City, 3-0. Days like this, it just makes you wonder about it all, really.
Arteta's got to go. Everything's got to change from top to bottom. The club is just, it's just rotten now.
Rodri. Manages to pass it in.
First game of the season, rubbish. Second game of the season, rubbish. We haven't scored a goal. We haven't even threatened to score a goal. It's terrible. It's the worst Arsenal team I've ever seen in my life, ever.
Martin Atkinson brings the game to a close.
It's dire, it's embarrassing.
I don't think I trust the process. I don't think the other fans trust the process. I don't even think the players trust the process.
First manager to get the sack, I promise you.
Do you want him there? Is he the man to take you to the next level?
You'd have to say no.
After three games, the table does not make happy reading for Arsenal. They sit bottom. To make matters worse, their North London rivals Tottenham are top of the league.
We're bottom of the league. 0 goals, conceded 9, 0 points. And we are getting hammered by everybody. It's the biggest challenge that I faced since I joined the club. In difficult moments, you question yourself, you have fears. Difficult things happen in your mind. You know, can I turn it around? Do I have the energy today to go back tomorrow and transmit what I have to transmit? How are we going to do it? Are people going to believe in what we are doing? You need the right people around you to support you and sometimes to help you lift when you are under difficulty.
How are you?
Yeah, it's good.
We need some stability. We don't need any of this. I was annoyed that there were so many people trying to fracture the group, you know?
You have experienced that a lot.
The only guys you can trust are the ones in the room with you. That's all I know.
That word is very rare to find. Eh?
Very. Very much, very much. But onward we go. Yeah. Part of my job is to be aware of certain narratives that are out there. That doesn't mean I believe them or actually pay attention to them, but I must be aware of what's being said. But, you know, I think that our main motto is tune out the noise, keep our heads down, and have each other's backs. At times, everybody needs to have an arm around their shoulder.
Just before the transfer window closes, Arsenal make one more signing.
We can start on right back. So sure. Tomiyasu has just finalised the deal with the player's agent.
It's literally just signing the paperwork now and them confirming they're happy with the medical. So that's all in hand.
Feels like we're in good shape.
Takehiro Tomiyasu, a Japanese international right back, is signed from Bologna for £17.5 million. In all, Arsenal has spent £156 million this summer. After 3 league defeats in a row, Mikel's thinking about making some changes. Bern Leno has been Arsenal's number one goalkeeper for 3 years. But now, new signing Aaron Ramsdale is in contention.
I know my position at the moment in time, and you have to get to the top, you have to try and beat the people at the top. You have to be selfish at times, because when you're a number one, you get the criticism, but you also get all the glamour and the praise, and you get the relief of playing the matches, and I think that's what's pushing me on at the moment. I know Norwich, it's a massive game, and my goal is to get into the team, to help the team improve on tough times we're having.
This is Arsenal's worst ever start in the Premier League. Everyone at Colney knows another defeat is unthinkable. they haven't lost their first four league games in almost 100 years.
Focus on first of all, let them play, for example, against the start without giving them much instruction, just to get the press beaten and run into the halfway line. How we do that? And let them play for 5 minutes.
He's dealt with pressure all his life, from when he was a young boy right the way through to playing at the highest level and now coaching and managing at the highest level. So I don't think he knows a world without it.
And then we will go to the 4 points that we discussed. Defending, about the aggression on the press.
The very best people in their roles at that level actually embrace it and need it. He's very focused and concentrated on what needs to be done.
That's it.
Okay, thank you.
Let's not hide from the fact that this is Arsenal. You have to make top four. Surely pride has to kick in, because I get annoyed when sometimes people have a go at the manager. Surely pride has to kick in, because I get annoyed when sometimes people have a go at the manager, saying, oh, he can't handle it. No, they cannot handle it.
After you lose two games in a row, it's bad. After you lose three, that's when it gets really, really bad. When you have 0 points on the board at the beginning of the season, it's just relegation form, literally.
I'm 22 and I haven't seen my club win the Premier League. And all my dad, my uncles, they've seen it all. And they always tell me, like, this is not the Arsenal. I'm not used to seeing this. Uncles, they've seen it all. And they always... Always tell me, like, this is not the Arsenal. I'm not used to seeing this.
Morning.
Mikel is a modern manager with progressive ideas. Along with the coaching team, he focuses on how to bring the best out of the players.
We talked in the office and we saw the images about what we want to work on. The number one thing, clean sheet, no goals, and do your role and your task as well as you can. Yeah? Let's go. Ben.
You have a level of aggression in some actions that you do, attacking and defending, Ben, that before I didn't see. And you have to get out of that system to become the leader in that backline.
We have a young team and I don't know if they're gonna handle that pressure. So I need to try to release pressure from them.
Again, bravo. Yes, Ainsley.
And they have to, at least from our side, in our bubble, feel that we trust them, that we have confidence in them, and that whatever what happens, we're going to defend them. And that's the approach that I try to take.
Why did you go then?
I didn't, I waited a bit.
Okay, when you waited and you went, what happened? He wasn't still there. So you have to speak.
From the moment he came in, I knew, like, he was going to be a top manager. Tactically, he's so good. The details he gives us and stuff just helps us so much. So
if there is no order, it's no creativity, it's just chaos. If you have to organize this chaos into something, then becomes really, really tricky.
Mikel is very, very special. Had already a lot of coaches, but he's a freak, but in a positive way, because he see details. I didn't have a coach, he see that.
Where he
connects the team and environment he creates here, I think is brilliant. And we need to get a win and get the team back to where it belongs.
Oh, 3-5-5, nice, Oak.
I feel lucky because I feel that the players, they are really convinced of what we are trying to do.
Guys, we start to win tomorrow. You know, if we lose and we don't score, we're gonna be the worst start of Arsenal. No, the worst start of the Premier League.
History.
In history.
In the history of the Premier League. Wow.
But we're gonna score, we're gonna win. I think 3-0 or 3-1.
Why 3-1? That means we always concede the goal.
3-0 or 3-1.
The coach say clean sheet.
Many football pundits believe that if Mikel loses this match, it'll be his last at Arsenal. After 3 league games, it's no goals and 9 conceded. This is the definition of a must win.
I think this game is absolutely crucial today. 3 points is a must. I think anything less than a clean sheet and a win, no.
It's good that we've got 4 players coming back, yeah. So we should be all guns blazing. And let's just hope he picks the right squad.
Hi,
we got car parking.
We've been told just to say his name, we've got a space. Thank you.
The Ramsdale family are dedicated followers of their son, Aaron.
Hi. Hello there. Hi. Other than COVID, I think my mum and dad have missed 2 games probably in 3 or 4 years. So to know I have them in the stands, it's great for me.
He's playing.
Hey! Fuck me, he's fucking starting.
Well, there's a debut after just 1 training session for the 22-year-old Japan international Takahiro Tomiyasu. But the big news is that Aaron Ramsdale is preferred in goal to Bert Leno, and Ramsdale makes his first league start for Arsenal.
He just come out on the pitch. I give a wave to my mum each game, and it's just nice, you know, it's making them proud, and it's just great to have the backing, because I know if I've done well, they'll tell me. If I've done badly, my dad will definitely tell me, so. Oh! He's on the front of the ground!
Do you think without their dedication or encouragement you'd be here?
There's no need to go further than that, absolutely not. There'd be no way I'd be sat here right now without them two.
How does he feel? That's what I think, how does he feel? I mean, I know he's buzzing, but good God. excited now.
It's been a long, emotional week for Mikel, and now he's ready to tell his team exactly how he feels.
Good afternoon, guys. Today I want to share with you a personal emotion and the reason why I'm here. In many industries, they are high performance teams. And these high performance teams are called like this because they all have something in common, because they get results. When I was born with a big heart disease. And for 2 years, they had to try to save my life till I had the opportunity to have the first open surgery in Spain. So a high performance team is not a football team, a basketball team. For example, it can be an emergency team is the one that they work, for example, in hospitals. So these teams have to be surrounded by people that they are very special. They're willing to work 24/7. They do it only for one reason, because they love what they do. Nothing else. That's the drive, that's the purpose. I'm going to share something with you. This is me. This is my emotional status. In the last 14 days, 1 to 10. Postman City. I was here. Dead. I was here. I had fear. I had insecurity. I have the media that is killing me. Suddenly, I have all the positives. I have an incredible family, a wife, 3 kids, another one. The club, always support me from the top, the owner, everybody. The biggest gap here, the moment that I go from here today like this, is you guys. Because this week I have found the purpose, why I want to be a coach, what I'm in the industry, why I have to be with these people. So for these guys, what I have to say, only from my side, is thank you so much to all of you, because you made, in a difficult moment, the best week of my football career. Believe in yourself. I do. You are really good. The last thing I want to do, me as a coach, is blame any of you in difficult moments. My responsibility, I take the shit. Let's go.
Spirits of a frustrated fan base. And Arsenal get this match underway. Big roar goes up around the stadium. Coming after him. Gonzalez. Early ball in.
Save it, Aaron. Save it, Aaron.
Pulls it right across. Nobody there. Max Aarons. Tries a shot.
Save it, Aaron.
It's a good save. Back from Williams. Dow plays one in. Takes a deflection. Might fall to Pookie. Ramsdale did well. Read it well.
Shit,
Ramsdale being penned back a little bit. Oh, Ramsdale, that was cool.
Fucking nothing to my fucking heart, this.
Here come the Canaries immediately with Zolis. Long shot from distance, well off target. Maitland-Niles looking for Aubameyang. So can Arsenal get some players into that box? Aubameyang. It might drop here to Saka. Takes a deflection. Must be no.
Fucking hell.
Hanley trying to win it back. Saka's got away from him. Chance for Arsenal now. Smith Rowe, he's away. This could finish the job, but saved by Krull. And there goes the final whistle. Relief all round here, Mikel Arteta and his coaching staff.
Yes! Get in! Fucking get in!
And the all-important 3 points are off the bottom, thankfully, of the Premier League table, and hopefully now it's onwards and upwards.
Emotionally, a difficult game to play, obviously, after three defeats. Coming here, you see it in bottom of the table, and everything to prove. But I think the boys play with a tremendous character, great attitude. Right from the beginning, you could see what we wanted to do. It was a really difficult game to play, because I know emotionally how you were feeling. I know the pressure is building, I know the crowd. I feel you were terrific, guys. Your attitude, it was fucking spot on. I thank you so much. Well done.
You've spoken ever since you've come in about getting that connection between the players and the fans.
Yes, I'm extremely grateful because I know that it's a difficult moment, but I just saw a crowd that's wanted to inspire the team.
I wouldn't say won over some fans, but I would say he definitely bought some time. Because now the games that we've got, they are all must wins.
I think he's got to get a positive result at the North London Derby. Then a lot more fans will feel a bit more relaxed, but there's still a lot of pressure on him.
Imagine scoring in the North London Derby, though.
I scored in a few derbies here at home, so I know what's the feeling.
Stop it, I mean.
is everything. You're taught to hate Tottenham from birth.
I just picture myself the whole week in a position where we are winning that game.
This is as big as it gets.
Oh, it's always in the bar! Save by